Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's cover the idea of potency from a sense of binding energy. During previous discussions on enzyme and ligand potency, we defined terms like IC50 and Ki for both enzyme inhibitors and antagonists, and EC50 and KD for agonist. What is the typical numerical value for the potency of an approved drug? Oral small molecule drugs normally have a potency of around 10 nanomolar. That's 10 to the minus 8th molar. Let's say almost all drugs fall in the range of 1 to 100 nanomolar potency. Some online resources, namely IUFAR's Guide to Pharmacology, report potency as PIC50, PKI, PEC50, or PKD. That is, when you say PKI, it is minus log of KI. If KI is 10 to the minus 8th molar, then PKI equals 8. So this is the kind of potency that a molecule should have after lead optimization as it advances into clinical trials. Let's focus on the potency measures. Ki and Kd. These are equilibrium constants. Here is the equilibrium of binding. That's association for a receptor ligand. R plus L goes to the RL complex. KD or Ki are both actually the reverse process. Dissociation. So the equilibrium constant for the reaction, as shown from the left to the right, the binding, is actually the inverse of our potency measure. 1 over KD. From this equilibrium constant, we can determine the free energy of binding using our free energy formula. So we'll replace K with 1 over KD. R is 0.00199, and the units on that are kcals per mole, degree Kelvin. T will be 298 K degrees Kelvin. What should we use for KD? Let's use 10 to the minus 8th molar. If we work through the math, the binding energy for a typical drug is minus 10.9 kcals per mole, and we can round that to minus 11 kcals per mole. Two comments. Comment number one, make sure your KD or Ki has units of molarity, not micromolar or nanomolar. Comment two, binding energy is negative because binding is favorable for a potent drug. Be careful with the negative sign. Binding energy is always negative for drugs, though some people will casually refer to the absolute value of binding energy. There are some variations for this equation, but all are mathematically equivalent. Let's do a couple potency calculations based on drugs found in IUFAR's Guide to Pharmacology. Here is a drug. Atorvastatin, also called Lipitor, it's a treatment for high cholesterol. Its potency as an enzyme inhibitor in humans is listed as 7.8, and that's the PKI. Remember, PKI is equivalent to the negative log of Ki or log of 1 over Ki. We can use this number directly in our equation for binding energy. So log of 1 over Ki is the same as PKI. So in place of here, we'll use 7.8. And if we go through the math using values of R and T, we get a binding energy of minus 10.6 kcals per mole, that's right about what we would expect. A typical drug is about 11 kcals per mole, minus 11 kcals per mole. There's another drug shown at the bottom. It's captopril. Captopril is a blood pressure drug. Its potency as an enzyme inhibitor is listed as 8.4. If we go through the math and use 8.4 in place of pKi, we get a binding energy of minus 11.5 kcals per mole. It's a bit stronger than atorvastatin, yet still within the range of a typical drug. I hope you now have a better handle on how potency connects to binding energy. If you have any questions, please share them in the comments below. Take care.